in the development of the National Case Management System, which is a coordinated and multi-sectoral approach to prevent all forms of child abuse, including child labor. At community level, the ministry is working with community child care workers, called CCWs, and ward level child protection committees, who assist in the identification and the referral of child protection and child welfare cases, inclusive of children at risk of child labor and those subjected to child labor. The system utilizes existing community structures and child protection stakeholders to identify and refer cases of child labor and child abuse to the Department of Social Development. At district level, the District Child Protection Committee is also in place, which reports to the Provincial Child Protection Committee and the National Child Protection Technical Working Group. Child labor issues are discussed in these platforms to ensure that systems are strengthened to prevent and respect, to respond to identified cases. The ministry also administers the Social Welfare Act, Chapter 17.06, and this has implications for children's rights, their protection, as well as specifically protection from child labor. This act generally provides for social protection to vulnerable groups and indigent persons to enhance the well-being of individuals and reduce vulnerability. This act seeks to promote family strengthening as a mechanism to prevent child neglect and abuse, among them being child labor. The prevention of child labor is being done through the provision of social protection services in the form of educational assistance and household economy strengthening, as explained in the following. Educational assistance is done through basic education assistance module, which is commonly known as BIM. The program seeks to ensure that the education of children is not interrupted as a result of various challenges that children may face. It is also a preventative measure for child labor, as it ensures that vulnerable children do not drop out of school, which at times leads them to be subjected to harmful labor practices. In 2021, the program has a target of 1.5 million children, and in the first quarter, 169,071 primary school children and 502 children from special schools for children with disabilities were assisted. The program has also been expanded to cover uniforms and stationery for children. The main challenge that we face relates to budgetary support, especially delays in disbursement of budgetary support for programs. This therefore delays implementation of programs and also limits the procurement of tools of trade and that is service delivery, such as station vehicles. Honorable Chair, I have been visiting some of our provincial offices as well as our district offices. The vehicles that I was in Mashingo recently, the vehicle that our provincial head uses in that process is probably 25 years old, and it's used to traverse very difficult roads in the rural areas. And that makes it very difficult for them to carry out their work. And we have appealed to Treasury for resources to equip our offices. Luckily this year we have been allocated funds, but the release has not come for the purchase of vehicles. We really need vehicles in all our departments, but I see that the Department of Social Development is better resourced than the Department of Labor. This is where the inspections take place. Without inspections, we cannot arrest some of these problems, especially of child exploitation through child labor.
For these and other stories, visit our website www.263chat.com. Follow us on Twitter @263chat and like our Facebook page 263chat.